metal plate reflects 80% of the light that falls on it. The plate is attached to a spring with an elastic constant K, initially relaxed, with an initial length X0. Light with intensity I0 begins to fall on the plate at an angle theta with the horizontal. What will be the final length reached by the spring in the final position of static equilibrium? Now see, this question makes use of the concept of radiation pressure. So let's review this concept. Imagine a beam of light that is a beam of photons, which will strike a wall and then end up applying a force F on this wall due to the collisions of the photons. So the concept of pressure, even in this context, is still the force that the photons will apply to that surface divided by the area. And this force will still be given by the
rate of change of the momentum of these photons, that is delta Q over delta T.
When the photon beam collides with the wall, it strikes with a quantity of motion, a linear momentum. The linear momentum of a photon with energy is divided by the speed of light, which is C. So it will hit with this momentum and be reflected. Therefore, the magnitude of the change in momentum of the photon from this collision,
what will it be given by? Well, here you will work only with the horizontal components of the momentum.
And you notice that the photon was moving to the right before, and after the impact, it's moving to the left.
So let's take only the horizontal component divided by the speed of light cosine of alpha.
So when I calculate the final amount of momentum minus the initial, notice that reversing the direction causes an inversion of the algebraic sign here. And you can't fall into that trap. So this would be the change in momentum, assuming an elastic collision where it hits and reflects with the same energy. Let's go.
Let's move on now to the calculation of radiation pressure. You will find that this pressure will be 1 over A times dq over dt. This ratio, energy divided by time, I will call power. And this ratio, power over area, is also known as the intensity of this beam.
And therefore, the radiation pressure as a function of the incident radiation intensity will be given by this expression. And remembering that the pressure force is the pressure times the area, let's find this force. Well, from now on, let's calculate the force that this radiation applies when it strikes this plate. Renato Brito, but haven't you already found this expression? Well, this expression assumes that 100% of the light is reflected, but in this case, only 80% of the light will be reflected.
So the force due to this 80% reflection will be 80% of that value.
Now remember that 20% of this radiation is incident and not reflected. It will be absorbed by this metal, so we will have an inelastic collision.
In the inelastic collision, you have this incoming beam, but you won't have this beam reflected. Therefore, when calculating the change in momentum, this term here is now zero. So the change in momentum in this situation will not result into E cosine alpha. It will no longer include these two. You see? Bye and now move on. So in this case, where the collision is inelastic, meaning the radiation is absorbed by the metal, that too will not appear. The expression for the force will then be the same expression here, just without that too. This would be the expression for the collision. Initially, it was 100% radiation absorbed by the metal, but in this case, only 20% will be absorbed by the metal.
So the force due to this absorption will be 20% of that result. Just to recap, this first term refers to the 80% that was reflected by the metal.
And this other term refers to the 20% of radiation that was absorbed by the metal. So the total force ends up being 1.6 plus 0.2, which is 1.8.
And therefore, Ilzia, in the final equilibrium situation, the force due to radiation will have to match the elastic force acting on this plate. So let's write this equilibrium equation. So here I will find the expression for the spring's deformation. Just take that force expression and divide it by the spring constant K. So finally, folks, what is the final length of the spring? Well, it's its initial length minus the deformation, which means
will be x0 minus this delta x. And that's the desired expression for the spring's final length. Are you enjoying the explanation? So you don't forget, leave a like for Renato Brito now and let's move on to the correct answer. If you pay attention, you'll notice that this 1.8 appearing here, o aqui seis,
it's exactly that 9/5, which is hidden in option C. So that's why the correct answer to this question is option C. Warm regards and see you next time.